I will show you how to block out a portrait with rough shadows and highlights. We will be using the lasso tool, brush tool, and smudge tool, and an image reference as our guide. Let's get started.
I'll be using a practice template that I've made here and also an image reference here to act as our guide. So now, let's open the template in Photoshop as well as the image reference. Let's put them side by side. Let me introduce my Photoshop interface a bit before we begin. On the left side here is the Photoshop toolbars. And on the right side here, there are currently three menus open: Color, Adjustments, and Layers. If you couldn't find these menus in your Photoshop interface, you can go to Windows and look for it. For colors, I use a HSB sliders to pick my colors. H is hue. It allows you to pick a color from the color wheel. S stands for saturation. It lets you adjust the intensity of the color. B stands for brightness. It lets you adjust the value. If you couldn't see the HSB slider in your Photoshop, you can click here and look for it. I will talk about adjustments later. As for the layers, let's click on our template PSD. As you can see here, these are the layers that I've prepared. I've named them accordingly. Now, let me show you my frequently used brushes. Let's click brush. This is my brush set.
You can also use your own brushes.
Here, you can find not only my brushes, you can also find my smudge tools. To differentiate what tools is that, you can look at the top right corner here. There's a brush icon here indicating that this is a brush tool. While this one, there's a smudge icon on the top right, meaning that this is a smudge tool. Now, let's use this image reference here as our lighting direction guide. In the reference here, the light comes from around 45 degrees from the front top. Therefore, I've drew a lighting arrow here to act as our lighting guide, which is the layer here. Let's start with the skin layer. Let's apply some rough shadows to it. Let's pixel lock the layer so that you can only paint in pixels that are opaque. We will start by blocking out the shadow. Let's use the lasso tool and make sure it's add to selection mode so you can make multiple selections. Let's select the main shadow area. Now, let's use the brush tool to paint in the shadow parts. I will use a soft round brush for this. Now, I will pick a shadow color. First, I will color pick the normal skin color here that we have. For darker color, let's increase the saturation and decrease the brightness. Let's change the brush mode here to multiply for shadow.
For this stage, it's important to use the brush in big size and paint without zooming in, so you don't overdo the details.
So now, let's just focus on the big shapes. Let's set the opacity to around 50% by pressing 5 on keyboard. Now let's paint in the shadows. We can deselect the selection by pressing Ctrl D on our keyboard. Now let's continue to refine using just a soft brush. Just adding some rough shadows. You can adjust your brush size accordingly for different parts of the portrait. Now, let's apply the same thing to the hair. Let's select the hair layer, pixel lock it. To choose a darker color, let's color pick the original hair color, increase the saturation, decrease the brightness, make sure the brush mode is set to multiply. Let's do the same for the shirt. Now, we will blend the hard edges that we have created with the lasso tool just now. To do that, I will use the smudge tool. Let's go to my brush set and select the soft smudge tool, which is very good in blending. Let's go back to our skin layer. Let's set the strength to 40%. Don't overdo this, a little bit will do. Right now, we already have our rough shadow. Let's apply some highlight as well. Use the soft brush here. Increase the brush size. For the highlight, we will color pick the original color and I will just increase the brightness here in the brightness slider. Then I will set the brush mode here to overlay and set the opacity to around 50% as well. Now let's apply the highlight. Now let's do the hair. Select the hair layer, color pick the hair color, increase the brightness. Make sure this is set to overlay. Right now, I think the color is too red. Let's go to the hue slider and change it to more yellow. Right now, I think it's slightly too yellow. Let's adjust it to a bit red. I think this is fine now. Let's do the same for the shirt. Color pick, increase the brightness. This will do.